Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has declared he wants to strengthen Australia's relationship with Indonesia as he prepares to meet with President Joko Widodo in Jakarta. Political editor Mark Riley is in Jakarta with the Prime Minister.
Yeah, Anthony Albanese is on his way to the presidential palace here in Jakarta, where he'll be greeted with all the bells and whistles of a red carpet welcome by his host, Indonesian President Joko Widodo, known to his people here as Jokowi. It is something of a tradition for a new Australian Prime Minister to come to Jakarta. Ceremonial and showy, but Mr. Albanese insisted this visit was about a lot more than just turning up for appearance's sake.
This is more than symbolic. This is a friendship which is deep. And I think it is significant that I've brought with me the Foreign Minister, the Trade Minister, the Industry Minister here as part of the delegation.
As part of that team, Foreign Minister Penny Wong had the first official meeting overnight with her counterpart Retno Masudi, with much to discuss, including China's current high-spending charm offensive in the Pacific.
What is important is that countries work together to ensure that region remains peaceful, prosperous and respectful of sovereignty.
China will also be a major topic of discussion when President Jokowi greets Mr. Albanese at the presidential palace in a few hours after the latest interception of an RAAF reconnaissance plane by a Chinese fighter jet.
This was not safe, what occurred, and we've made appropriate representations to the Chinese government expressing our concern at this.
The leaders will also discuss Indonesia's decision to invite both Russia's Vladimir Putin and Ukraine's Volodymyr Zelensky to the G20 summit it's hosting in Bali in November. US President Joe Biden wanted Russia booted out of the G20. Mr. Albanese is a little more diplomatic.
People who respect human rights would feel uncomfortable with sitting around the table with Vladimir Putin.
Anthony Albanese says, in his words, there is a new show in town in Australia and that his government wants to forge a deeper and more enduring relationship with the nations of Southeast Asia, and this is seen as a first step in that process.
Thank you, Mark.